It's the core gameplay, and today I'm showing you how to build this Puckle Tower or Puckle Hut. We're going to go in detail what this is used for, and I'll show you how to build the foundation. I think it's a hexagon, but we'll see. Okay, so first of all, this thing is designed to protect your main base. It is a separate Puckle Tower, which you can spawn in, you can keep loot in, and of course, you can kill people with it. It tries to raid you. So basically, if you see the NPCs, you'll think, oh, they can't shoot through, but actually they can. I'm going to punch this beehive a bit, and you'll see bees will spawn, and they will kill it. So let me punch this one. See, they instantly kill the bee. I'm going to do that side as well. It's quite convenient that these beehives are here, but if you punch beehives, they will spawn. So you can see they can actually shoot. Let's see if this one can do it as well. And you can see 360, they have coverage. Sometimes they even overlap on the corners when something is here. If you want to probably siege this thing, this will be the weakest point because that's the entrance. So let's take a look what's inside. Why would you want to go inside? And everything. I could have gone with a square, but I thought this design is a bit more interesting. It is double walled, since you need to go through this and then you need to go through a wall, you know, on the inside as well. I decided to make a double wall. I wanted something with double walls because it's more optimal for PvP, even though this tower is not probably the strongest. It's just here to annoy your opponent if they want to raid you. Put a little sign there so you don't get confused. But basically inside the space you've got your food or table or mess table, your ammo box, your resource box, a smithy to repair stuff in case you want it, and a few storage boxes so that you can put your armor and snipers and everything else that you want to use for PvP. Let's say you put this, you put four of these on the sides of your base. Maybe you put one in front in the middle here, one on the side a little bit further out, and some more, and one on this side as well. Then they will protect your base, make sure people don't run up on you. Plus they need to take this out before they can siege your base. So this is basically the purpose of it. So how do you start building this? Basically you start with foundations. Let's see if I can... Ooh, they're killing something. I think it's a bird. Basically how you start is you need a two foundations, take two like this, and then you switch to a triangle. Let's make it a different type of foundation. So you've got your two foundations. Oh shit, that poor crow. You got your two foundations, and then you start building two foundations again. Once you've got that, you'll see starts taking shape. Take your triangle again, and then build out two foundations again, and you can see it's really starting to take shape. There's your basic shape, and you do this all the way around until you get the basic shape, and then you start building this out. Now how do you do this? Here I've got like a ceiling or a slope roof. You switch it to doors, door frames, or before you build anything, you're going to have to put the doors down, otherwise you won't be able to place the ceilings. Place these door frames all the way around. I would suggest that you place a door frame here, skip one, and then place it one here, and every second one you place one down, and then you fill up all the door frames around. Otherwise this door frame might snap to this door frame, and if they kill this door frame, everything will demolish. So every second door frame you do this, and you place one down. Once you place one down, you can start placing your doorways. Place a doorway, same thing, every second doorway you place first. So you will place a doorway here, then you will skip this one, and you will start placing one here, skip this one, place one here, skip this one, place one here, skip this one, and you continue like that until you have at least one on each side, and then you will fill up all the other stuff because otherwise if you keep just placing one here and then one here, they will snap to each other, and if they destroy this one, the whole thing will collapse. So you don't want that. After that, you want to switch to your triangle pieces, triangle roof pieces. They look like this. Then you just press Q and it should snap into place. Same thing, snap them all into place at the bottom. Then when you start with the top, same thing, you're going to place every second one first. So you're going to place one here, one here, one here, one here, and one here, until you have it all the way around. And then you'll fill everything up. Once you're done filling everything up, you're going to place one here, and then you just fill the other two as well. Then you will have a great little Puckle Tower that can protect your main base. It's mainly used to protect your main base, not really anything else, since there's no cannons or anything on this. So I hope this video was helpful. If it was helpful and you like this build, then give this video a like. And if you want to see more videos like this and you want to help me reach 1,000 subscribers, then you can subscribe, and I'll see you in my next video. Thank you for watching.